2019 was marked by the start of operations for AOLUS, the first ever satellite to analyze global wind patterns using a laser Doppler. Data provided by AOLUS is an invaluable tool for weather forecasting, increasing accuracy and giving insights about winds. Earth observation measurements provided by the Sentinel satellites of Europe's Copernicus program or by ESA Earth explorers such as AOLUS or SMOS continue to give interesting and useful data about climate change and the health of our planet. Climate change is one of the biggest challenges today, and data from space is key to understand the situation. Another Sentinel satellite is ready for launch in 2020. Sentinel-6 will study sea level rise on a global scale, one of the key indicators of climate change. ESA is already preparing the next generation of Sentinel, for example, checking future instruments to fly over the Arctic region and analyze the sea ice shield. ESA continues to secure an independent access to space for Europe with the preparation of a more powerful Vega. Earlier this year, the new motor common to Vega-C and Ariane 6 was tested twice at Europe's spaceport in Kourou. Also, the Ariane 6 launch pad is clearly taking shape. Last summer, an Ariane 5 launched EDRS-C, a telecom satellite from Kourou, to complete the European data relay system that uses optical laser connections between satellites for faster data exchange. In July, Italian ESA astronaut Luca Parmitano was launched from Baikonur for his second long-duration mission to the International Space Station. He is the third ESA astronaut who was entrusted as commander of the space station. He demonstrated the possibility to control a rover on Earth from orbit. This showed the value of human-robotic cooperation in space, key for many future exploration projects. Luca Parmitano is also part of the most complicated series of spacewalks ever. For the repair of AMS, the Alpha Magnetic Spectrometer, outside ISS, three spacewalks have been performed successfully so far. AMS looks in particular for dark matter and antimatter, measuring cosmic rays. It has exceeded its lifetime and was not designed for any maintenance, making it difficult to repair this precious tool that has given groundbreaking results to the scientific community. In science, the European Space Agency is always at the forefront. A good example is a new release of the Gaia catalogue, offering the best mapping of the Milky Way. Cheops, the characterizing exoplanet satellite, will study known exoplanets, which are orbiting bright stars. This new telescope was launched from Kourou in mid-December. ESA is also ready to study our own star, the Sun, the source of life on Earth. Early 2020, Solar Orbiter will be launched from Florida. This mission will help us understand how our star behaves and interacts with the entirety of our solar system. 3 years after its historical landing on a comet, Rosetta is still a goldmine for discoveries. Scientists are still using its data to learn more about comet life and how they evolve, giving clues about our solar system. 2019 ended with the success of Space 19+ ESA Ministerial Conference that took place in Seville. ESA member states supported the agency with its biggest budget ever, allowing for new missions, securing independent access to space, and ambitious scientific goals for the future of Europe in space. As the year ends, the future begins.